sharply in focus for this fixture, for both mascots come from the same family. Mark Hayes on the left, 11 years old, supports Crystal Palace, but his younger brother Ian, who's now 8, claims that he's been a Wolves supporter since he was 3 years old. And each has one new player to look at in his side today. For Crystal Palace, it's the former Tottenham Hotspur striker Chris Jones, who was signed from Manchester City on Thursday. And with Ian Edwards and Tommy Langley both injured, he goes straight into the side. And he's the one change in the team compared with last week when they went away for the first time at Leicester. Jim Cannon, the skipper who was injured then, has recovered and is fit. The new man in the Wolves lineup is Alan Dodd, signed from Stoke City also on Thursday. And he moves into a change defence which sees John Pender, 19 years old, recalled at number 5. Wolves trying to end a sequence which has seen them concede 4 goals on the last 2 Saturdays. And back at Selhurst Park comes an old favourite, John Burridge, very much a part of the happy palace of the late 70s, before the days of so many changes behind the scenes. Crystal Palace defending the only unbeaten home record in the second division. First header was from Billy Gilbert, and Palace playing from left to right. Joe Gallagher is the player who's been replaced by Pender for being, I suppose we could put it, 25% inefficient. Nearly worked by Kevin Mabbott. There. Mabbott again. Brother of the Tottenham and England Mabbott. Plenty of time for Cannon. Placed now by Mel Eves, but not for long. Jones. Jeff Palmer. First cry of Eagles, nickname of Crystal Palace. Marvellous header. Jim Cannon the scorer. And John Burridge never saw it. And again, Wolves concede a goal from a set piece, and that has been their problem recently. Flew off the head of Cannon, as his name would suggest. And certainly, John Burridge was blasted. The goal coming just into the second minute. And it certainly sent a buzz around the ground. Eves, can he get there? He can, it's a good save. And Gray just over the top. That's what you might call a lively beginning. Free kick against Gilbert. And the referee, who has already been end-to-end, is Alan Robinson of Waterlooville in Hampshire. Great. So he might have been pulled a bit then. Jerry Murphy. Henry Houghton. Or even Vince Allaire. Jones, yes! Well, he steered it in well, and Alan Dodd is the player left sitting down. Chris Jones takes a little over 4 minutes to score his first goal for Crystal Palace. and the man he just got the better of was the other newcomer, Alan Dodd, who just failed to mark him on the near post. Oh, some opening for Crystal Palace. Ten goals past Wolverhampton Wanderers in two matches and another 4 minutes of the third game. Geoff Palmer. Out by Cannon. And the flag up for offside. Still finding time to say some things. He's a bit greedy. John Burridge's view of Paul Baron's clearance. Cannon. Free kick is in Wolves' favour. Can you hear us on the box? Well, we can certainly see them, that's for sure. Great. Hilaire. Hibbitt there first. Palmer. Could be promising. And it's in. And the scorer is Mick Matthews. What a long diagonal ball. Went across four defenders, a simple nod back, and Matthews makes it 2-1. And the latest statistic is 3 goals in 7 minutes. Free kick has been given. Taken. Murphy, Hilaire, Mavitz. Offside flag. On by Eves. Fouls as the referee. It's a look we've seen before. And the look was at the linesman. Gilbert at Gray's back. Hibbitt. That's nice. Hilaire left. Palmer. Oh, what a good save! Really fine save by Baron from Mel Eves. We can see why Alan Mullery, when we looked at him, was waving the players forward. No time with 2 goals in 4 minutes to sit back on it. Bit of pushing. Wouldn't have counted anyway. Ian Cartwright, yet ready to get into the game, the 17-year-old. Good throw out by Paul Baron. Dodd. Clark. Eves, if he can take it, and he can, Baron to meet him. And left him very little to shoot at. In the carpet. Gray. Hibbitt. What a nice opportunist try. It's two each. And there's the most disappointed man. He did well to get to that from Wayne Clark. The scorer smiles. And the goalkeeper looks the exact opposite. And the score is 2-2. 34 minutes gone, and Wolves have recovered from the disastrous 4 minutes which opened the match, and they conceded the two. Hilaire. Still teasing them. Lovely player with such natural ability, although one does wonder why he's not yet really made the breakthrough, because he's so gifted. Of the manager's emotions in 34 minutes. That could be problems. Here's Gray for Eves. Just had a bit too much on it. Side are in attacking positions. That's Burridge's. Cannon! Well, John Burridge came for it. He must have known that having come for it, it should have been his. Instead, he let it go away. But Cannon couldn't take the advantage. Hibbitt. Gray! Yes! Lovely header! That's a peach! Really good move by Wolves, and finished quite exquisitely by Andy Gray. Just the brush of the forehead, tucked it inside the post. And from two down, Wolves now lead 3-2. Here's Clark. Cartwright, Eves got back onside in time. Clark, good challenge by Gilbert. Corner. Gray wants it again. Good height on the header from Murphy. Hemel. Gilbert, the offender. Need the half-time break. Can't come quick enough for them. Fender is up. But it's too long for everybody. It would have gone on its own. An indication of how fortunes have changed. Gilbert felt compelled to put the ball out. Clark comes for the short one. Hibbitt's. referee has looked twice at his watch. And the free kick for Palace. Murphy takes, on by Jones. And Jones, one of the five scorers in an eventful half. A half which has seen a remarkable comeback, although the story is only halfway through. John Burridge beaten twice inside 4 minutes, but it was a moment of bad luck concerning the other goalkeeper, Paul Barron, which really turned the game. When Clark got the equaliser, and Gray with an exquisite goal giving Wolves a half-time lead. Now, before today's match, only four players in the Crystal Palace side have scored in league football this season. They've increased that total by 50%, and even so are on the wrong end of a total of five goals. Steve Lovell. Battling by Chris Jones. Beaten in the end by Pender. Giles being encouraged to play it back to Paul Barron. Really was unlucky, the equaliser at 2-2. Hilaire. Oh, it's worked for him. Oh! Matthews, who gave it to John Burridge. Burridge had the drop on it pretty quickly. But it won't reach him. A bit of improvisation by Alan Dodd. He rather telegraphed his clearance. This is Hinchelwood. Oh yes, it's in! Well, determination saw the clearance early, but there is no doubt that while the scorer gets the congratulations, there were one or two looks at John Burridge in front of the populace, who used to almost worship him. He's made a mistake. He obviously thought that was going wide. Instead of that, it tucked itself into the corner, and with 56 minutes gone, it's 3-3. Moments of panic there too. Eaves was wide. Jones. Hibbitt. Hinterwood did. Why not him? Oh, it's a good save. In truth, a rather harder shot than the one by Hinterwood which scored. Burridge gets the congratulations. Palace got a corner. Can unprepared for the long run in. Gilbert is ahead of him. Out by Gray. It's another thing he's done very well. Pender. Cannon. Well used by Gilbert. Well, it should have been. Hilaire. First he was pulled, and then he was flattened, and John Humphrey were quite right to get booked. Not just for that challenge, but there have been one or two what one might describe as physical assaults on Vince Hilaire. Pinchwood. free kick for a second piece of holding. Six on the edge of the 18-yard line. Mabbott, Hewton, Jones, Lovell. Murphy did well to let it run. Now Cannon. It didn't fall quite as he would have liked. He had to rather poke at it. But it was enough to send Burridge scurrying across his goal. Matthews. Clark. Humphrey. All waiting. And that's a fine goal by Matthews. His second of the match. 72 minutes gone. And Wolves are ahead again. With another finely directed header. And the long cross, which Mick Matthews turned away quite superbly. Graham Hawkins, the Wolves manager, has now come down to join his number two, Jim Barron, on the bench. He must, like the rest of us, be wondering whether there are any more twists to come. The Wolves, having conceded four goals last Saturday and the Saturday before, this time scored four. That's a good ball from Hinchelwood. And a good block by Cartwright. It's a corner. Taken quickly, Giles. Hilaire! Oh, blocked on the line! Unbelievable clearance off the line. And it was made by the man who scored two goals, Mick Matthews. Gray offside against Eames, but the referee will allow play to continue. Mr. Robinson looks for the first time at his watch. Three to Wolves it is. Marvellous entertainment. Andy Gray goes to take the referee's hand. Scorer of a magnificent goal himself. But it's the man who scored twice, Mick Matthews, who in the end decided the match in Wolves' favour on a score of 4-3.